When families go to Children's Hospital, they often face big odds. But as WDSU News anchor LaTanya Norton shows us, one boy faced those odds and he beat them. She has Jack's remarkable story of survival.
It all started when Jack was just 2 years old and running fevers. Then Jack's father noticed him poking something in his mouth.
So we look in his mouth, and he's got this big growth in his mouth, like this big, half of his mouth, it's tonsil, and it was bleeding.
5 weeks later, Jack was diagnosed with stage 2 lymphoma, a cancer that begins in the lymphatic cells of the immune system. Jack spent 3 months at Children's Hospital. His mother was pregnant at the time.
When your kid has cancer, everything in the world stops. Everything stops. And everything becomes not very important.
You're always keeping up with schedules. What do you do next? What do you do next? So Jack would go through a round of chemo, and he would get sick and nauseous all the time, and his eyes are sinking so far back in his head, and his hair is falling out.
But losing his hair didn't faze Jack.
We thought it'd be kind of traumatic for him, but he was just taking it out by the bunches and throwing it at us.
Neither did all the painful spinal taps.
He would have a spinal tap and then be watching Mickey Mouse.
But for mom and dad, the treatment took its toll. They found themselves leaning more and more on Children's Hospital.
Even when we didn't know we were leaning on them, we were leaning on them, and they were there.
These people are like the special forces. You know, they're so well trained, and their main training is stay calm. And the reassurance we got while here, you just always felt like everything was being done and everything was going to be okay.
And Jack is okay. Today, he's in remission.
We're probably talking about 90-95% survival. And he's done very well since then. He's had no evidence of any kind of recurrence. We anticipate that he'll grow up to be a strapping young man.
But for now, he's just a brave little boy who loves to cling to his warm blanket while warming the hearts of those he meets.
There's just no thank you big enough for what they do.
Right. And they let him be a kid. You know, I mean, you could see him running around. It's hard to keep them still. They knew, they let him be a kid here. It was just such a load off our minds to know that he could do what he needed to do here, which was be two.
On your side, LaTanya Norton, WDSU News.
And you can learn more about the miracles that happen at Children's Hospital during the Children's Miracle Network Telethon. It starts Saturday at 1 o'clock right here on WDSU. You can also watch our coverage on our Exact Weather Channel. The times and channels are right there on your screen. You can also check them out on WDSU.com. You don't